When Emile Cairess was younger, his only goal in life was to run around the streets of West Yorkshire faster than his mother. Motivated by his mother, who jogged for fitness, the four-year-old found it difficult to go around the block, much less keep up with her. Now that he is 26 years old, he is able to move on from his cherished mother and live a happy life with his athlete girlfriend, Georgie Yearby, while also leaving behind many of the top long-distance runners in the world. He became the second fastest British marathon runner in history today, taking an incredible third place in the London Marathon, demonstrating this fact to everyone. The Bradford lad is expected to assume Sir Mo Farah's role as the face of British long-distance running, earning him a spot at the Summer Olympics in Paris. It is a big cry from his modest upbringing in the English North, and things could have turned out quite differently. Emile had to decide when he was still a teenager between his two greatest passions, football and running. Emile, who was in love with Thierry Henry and aspired to be a right-winger like his idol at Arsenal, chose athletics over football because of his school's reputation and his realization that he was not going to succeed. As the most recent athlete to graduate from the £15,000 per year private school, Bradford Grammar has produced a long list of accomplished athletes, including the triathlete twins Alistair and Jonathan Brownlee. He attended the school on a bursary. He continued his education at St. Mary's University in London, where he ran distances in addition to his academics. Outside of the roads and the track, he forged a happy friendship with fellow athlete Georgie Yearby, which has endured for the past 6 years. But Emile kept pursuing his long-distance goals, while she stayed to the shorter distances, mostly 800-meter track competitions. After taking home a bronze in the 10,000 meters at the 2019 European Under-23 Championships, his talent was evident to everybody. Even more spectacularly, he would rank second at the 2022 European Cross Country Championships, only behind Norway's Jakob Ingebrigtsen, who has since developed into one of the world's fastest 5,000-meter runners, and win a silver medal. With a time of 45.57, he would also surpass the 30-year-old 10-mile record held by fellow Bradford Grammar alum Richard Nuriker. Given that he trained under Alan Storey, the former coach of the double Olympic champion, comparisons to Farah are inevitable. At the age of 24, Emile also tied Farah's record for the 10,000 meters on the road, clocking in at 27 minutes and 44 seconds. Emile has been vocal about his respect for his fellow Briton. He said to Runner's World last week, "With Mo Farah, when I was younger and he was doing the 2012 Olympics, I was at such a different level that it felt like he was almost doing a different sport." Although he was directly inspired by school runners a year above him, he acknowledged that becoming the fastest Briton over 10,000 meters on the road was a really cool achievement. "I would have been shocked if I had told myself that when I was younger," he continued. Even so, he acknowledges that he was in his early 20s when he set the objective of beating or matching Farah's record, saying it was there for the taking. Emile is driven by a desire to be the greatest. He has stated that he wants to set all the British road records, and that it's difficult to achieve big things without goals. But in recent years, Emile's attention has been drawn to the marathon, which is also the reason for his public recognition. In 2023, he participated in his first London Marathon and finished in sixth place with a time of 2 hours 8 minutes and 7 seconds, an amazing accomplishment considering his lack of experience. His accomplishment was further enhanced when it was revealed that he completed the 26.2-mile course wearing sneakers intended for 10-kilometer races and donning a Casio watch that would have been appropriate for the 1970s. His goals are to win an Olympic medal, smash Farah's British record of 2 hours 5 minutes and 11 seconds, and beat his own personal best of 2 hours and 3 minutes in the event. Before the race this year, he stated to The Guardian, "I want to run as fast as possible and I feel like I can run a lot quicker than that in the future. I also want to win an Olympic medal. I'm going to Los Angeles for that. I would like to compete in this Olympics though, if I can make it. I wouldn't go there merely to add up the figures." Although his goal was to reach the international distance running standards, There is always a chance that an athlete won't measure up, and like every long-distance runner, preparation is the key to success. Renato Canova, an Italian coach who has trained multiple marathon winners, has been spending every January in Kenya for the past 3 years in an attempt to take advantage of their system. He told Runner's World, "Seeing how they achieve such success through a minimalist lifestyle is really inspiring and humbling. So many people in Britain overcomplicate things by getting hung up on the intricacies of training, technology, and specialized diets. Life is quite easy in Kenya. The mindset of Kenyans is one that many British might take a lot to heart. Simply enjoy running and train extremely hard. Take care of the fundamentals, like getting enough sleep and recuperating well, and you'll perform well." His efforts were rewarded on Sunday as he finished the London Marathon in third position with a timing of 2 hours 6 minutes and 46 seconds, over half a minute faster than the previous year. Since Farah did it in 2018, it was the first time a British guy had placed on the podium at the London Marathon. Still holding the British record, Farah's performance from the Chicago Marathon 6 years ago, 2 hours 5 minutes and 11 seconds, was not met by his rival. Before the race, Cairess told Athletics Weekly that he did not anticipate setting any records this weekend, but he was confident that he would beat Farah's time. "Quite soon. I believe I can surpass that time eventually," Cairess disclosed. "My goal is to surpass it by a significant margin and compete in events such as the London Marathon and the Olympics in the future. But a marathon takes time. You need to take it gradually, even if your training has gone well. You can't do this or that. It's a procedure. I must exercise patience." Emile booked his spot for the Paris Olympics with an amazing time, matching his training buddy and lead city teammate Phil Seaman. Another British runner, Mahamd, is also in the running for a berth on Team GB. Mahamd put up a similarly strong performance today to finish fourth in the London Marathon. He honored his cousin, who was involved in an automobile accident 6 months prior, by his performance at this year's marathon. "I felt good, but it was windy," he stated. "I finished in third place by following my race strategy. I'm quite pleased with that. It essentially indicates that I was chosen for the squad, and I will be present. Before the Olympics, I had to do another marathon. It was a risk that paid off. I don't believe I was fit enough to set the British record." Even yet, he is hesitant to draw too many parallels with Farah, maintaining that the two athletes are totally different. "He was one of the best ever," he said to The Guardian. "He completely crushed the World Championships and the Olympics, and I will never be able to compete at that level. He seemed to be more on the track, and I feel like a road runner. We're not the same kind of person either. Thus, it may be the same Emile Cairess rather than the new Mo Farah.